Welcome aboard Steelaway, our 1987 Hunter 35 Legend. We sail around the Lake Erie Islands, and we're looking for an expensive DIY way to convert all of our sailing electronics and get them to talk to each other. Our original goal was to come up with a wind speed that my wife and I could agree upon that was too windy to go out sailing. We also wanted to connect the emergency button on our VHF radio to our GPS. After watching some videos of what other people had done, I also thought it would be fun to do some other things, like get all our data on one screen, input AIS data, be able to put it wirelessly over to people's phones or tablets. And most of all, I wanted to do it myself. We decided to create a network using NMEA 0183 technology, which is relatively old, but it was within my capabilities, and it seems to have worked out great. Here is how I took the existing equipment that came on my Hunter 35, and I networked it together to create a NMEA 0183 network. The previous owners of our boat had left us a few toys to play with. They left us a Lowrance chart plotter that's about a vintage 2006. It also provides depth and water temperature. It's a little quirky to use, but most of the newer stuff I've looked at really isn't any better. They also left us a standard Horizon VHF radio. It can connect to a GPS and contact the Coast Guard if you press an emergency button. This function wasn't enabled by our previous owners, as they had not registered an MMSI number, which you can get for free from Boat US, or connected it to the GPS, so we wanted to make sure that worked as we started going out further and further into the lake. When we sold our old boat, I wasn't quite sure what we were getting into, so I kept this old GPS receiver. If the GPS receiver sends out NMEA 0183 sentences, it doesn't really matter what brand it is. Our boat also came with an old Auto Helm 4000 autopilot. It still works great, but it doesn't connect to anything, so we just kind of left it out of the system and use it independently. After figuring out what I had, I went about designing my new system. Basically, I wanted to take the information I had from my old instruments, plus wind and AS because I thought it was fun, and be able to distribute it on any screen I wanted to put on the boat. The brains of any NMEA 0183 system is a multiplexer. Basically, what this does is it takes all the information that's coming in all the time from all the instruments, and then it puts it into one string that's in order and legible to all the other receiving instruments. I picked this one because it had a USB output, but I never really used it, so I'm not sure that was really all that important. There's a whole slew of them on the market, and even ones that include Wi-Fi now, which I had to include with a Wi-Fi bridge. Knowing how windy it is the original reason we started this project in the first place. I picked this anemometer from Clipper Marine because it sends NMEA 0183 sentences down and doesn't need its own independent display. It's relatively inexpensive, and it's a great reason to go up the mast. Most AIS receivers I looked at were really expensive. I found this one for under $100 from a gentleman, I believe in Seattle, and I picked it because it's relatively low cost, we're doing this just for fun, and it had a serial output that made it easy to connect to our network. Some of the multiplexers I've seen recently have built-in Wi-Fi, but the one I got didn't, so I had to buy a Wi-Fi router. I looked on the internet and tried to find a number of RS-232 Wi-Fi routers that were relatively inexpensive, but they were all sold out at the time I was trying to buy them. I bought this off a gentleman from Australia, and it's worked great. It was easy to connect, and it was relatively inexpensive. The wiring of our network was relatively straightforward. Most NMEA 0183 instruments involve a positive, a common, and then a data transmission line. Some instruments involve a positive and a negative power, and then a positive and a negative data transmission. It really just involves taking all your instruments that are producing information, wiring them into the inputs, and taking the instruments that are receiving information and wiring them into the outputs. After that, mine required very little configuration. I mounted my new instruments on a small board and mounted them in the back of the electrical panel in my nav station. They take up relatively little space, and no one ever even really knows they're there. Please don't look at my wiring as I've improved my cable management since then. Once you finish wiring up your network, you need something to display it on. Here I'm displaying mine on a small laptop, but you can put it on a tablet or even a phone, anything that will connect to the wireless network. The network will connect to most charting programs. Here I'm using OpenCPN. I've enjoyed to use it because there are lots of videos on YouTube on how to use it, and I found it to be relatively simple. You can download it for free. I chose to give them a donation. Here you can see my boat in red near the bottom, and all the other boats with AIS driving around the Lake Erie Islands. Also has our apparent wind speed. I haven't quite figured out how to get true wind speed, which is a calculation to work on it yet, along with our depth and water temperature from our Lowrance system. Well, enough boat work. The season up here on Lake Erie is short, so now it's time to go sailing.